हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर इन लेक्चर 4 ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैनेजमेंट फंक्शंस। आई होप यू हैव सीन द प्रीवियस 3 वीडियोस। एज इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव रेड अबाउट व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट। देन वी आर एक्चुअली इनटू दैट पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। देन इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज इन 3 ऑल्टरनेटिव वेज हाउ वी डू एक्चुअली लर्न अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट। देन व्हाट इज मैनेजमेंट, देन विथ रेफरेंस टू देन डिफरेंट पर्सन्स, द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट वी हैव स्टडीड एज पर एफ डब्ल्यू टेलर, हेनरी फायल, पीटर ड्रकर। एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन इज मैनेजमेंट इज द आर्ट ऑफ गेटिंग द थिंग्स डन थ्रू विथ पीपल। दैट मीन्स इफ यू हैव दैट पर्टिकुलर आर्ट टू गेट द थिंग्स डन बाई अदर पीपल विलिंगली, ओके, इट इज़ नॉट बाई फोर्सफुली, दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन टू हुम यू आर अलॉटिंग द वर्क, ही हैज़ टू विलिंगली डू दैट पर्टिकुलर वर्क, देन यू हैव दैट पर्टिकुलर स्किल ऑफ यू हैव दैट पर्टिकुलर मैनेजमेंट स्किल्स वेयर यू हैव द एबिलिटी टू गेट द वर्क डन बाई अदर्स। सो डिफरेंट कंटेक्स्ट, टुडे विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट डिफरेंट कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ डिफाइनिंग द मैनेजमेंट। सो देर आर 4 डिफरेंट ओरिएंटेशंस, 4 कंटेक्स्ट वेयर वी कैन डिफाइन दिस पर्टिकुलर मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस। द 4 डिफरेंट कंटेक्स्ट और ओरिएंटेशंस आर प्रोडक्शन और एफिशिएंसी ओरिएंटेड, देन डिसीजन ओरिएंटेड, देन वी हैव पीपल ओरिएंटेड एंड फंक्शन ओरिएंटेड। सो लेट अस स्टडी एक्चुअली इन डिटेल्ड अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर डिफरेंट कंटेक्स्ट। हाउ डू वी डिफाइन मैनेजमेंट बेस्ड ऑन दिस 4 पैरामीटर्स और 4 ओरिएंटेशन। सो फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोडक्शन और एफिशिएंसी ओरिएंटेड। सो नाउ हियर हाउ डू वी डिफाइन मैनेजमेंट इज यू सी प्रोडक्शन इज व्हाट? प्रोडक्शन इज दैट वेयर यू प्रोड्यूस समथिंग। यू हैव द रिसोर्सेस विथ यू, यू हैव द मटेरियल विथ यू हैव द मशीनरी विथ यू हैव द मनी विथ यू, रॉ मटेरियल। देन यू नो इफ एवरी इन्ग्रीडियंट और इफ एवरी रिसोर्स इज प्रेजेंट विथ यू, इफ यू नो वॉट टू डू विथ दोज रिसोर्सेज, देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोडक्शन ओरिएंटेड मैनेजमेंट। आई होप यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग। सो इट्स एन आर्ट ऑफ नोइंग एक्चुअली वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू डू एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग, दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग विच यू आर गोइंग टू डू एंड विच यू नो दैट हाउ टू डू इट। इफ यू कैन डू इट इन द बेस्ट वे एंड द चीपेस्ट वे विथ लेस कॉस्ट, देन वी कैन से और वी कैन डिफाइन मैनेजमेंट एज प्रोडक्शन और एफिशियंसी ओरिएंटेड। नाउ सेकेंड वन इज़ डिसीजन ओरिएंटेड। नाउ वेयर द बींग ह्यूमन बींग्स मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम एवरी डे एवरी नाउ एंड देन वी टेक डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ डिसीशंस। नाउ दोज डिसीशंस वेयर इट इज़ डायरेक्टली अफेक्टिंग द गोल्स, द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गोल्स। सो वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से ओवर हियर इज हाउ मैनेजमेंट कैन बी डिसीशन ओरिएंटेड। नाउ इट्स सिंपली ए डिसीशन मेकिंग प्रोसेस वेयर द ह्यूमन बींग्स आर द पर्सन्स हु आर वर्किंग इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दे एक्सप्रेस दे एक्शंस, द एक्शंस ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स वेयर द डिसीशन मेकिंग इज एक्सप्रेस्ड वेयर इट इज डायरेक्टली लिंक्ड अप विथ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गोल्स विच इज प्री डिटरमाइंड इन नेचर। सो इन ऑर्डर टू अटेन और इन ऑर्डर टू गेट दोज गोल्स, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल गोल्स, यू आर टेकिंग द डिसीशन, ओके। सो इट इज इन लाइन विथ दैट पर्टिकुलर डिसीशन ओरिएंटेड प्रोसेस, सो मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस। सो द थर्ड वन इज पीपल ओरिएंटेड, वेयर इट इज अकॉम्प्लिशमेंट ऑफ द रिजल्ट्स थ्रू द एफर्ट्स ऑफ अदर पीपल। दैट मीन्स यू सी वी कैनॉट रन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विदाउट मैन पावर। सो द पीपल ओरिएंटेड मैनेजमेंट मीन्स वेयर द एफर्ट्स ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी इंडिविजुअल वर्किंग इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज टेकन इन टू कंसिडरेशन एंड इन दोज केसेस इट इज कॉल्ड एज पीपल ओरिएंटेड मैनेजमेंट। देन Function oriented. Function oriented means that particular in an organization we do have organizations, and in that organizations we do have departments which does different management techniques, which follows different management techniques, or which has different functions which it is carrying out in that particular management. That means one department is forecasting the things, one department is planning, one department is scheduling and organizing, one department is having the what you can say, skills or the art of coordinating the things done by other people and controlling the things. So all these function oriented which I am talking about, where the different functions of management are coming into picture, so that is called as function oriented. Now here we have studied about the topic, just rewind, that we have studied about the different contexts of how we define the management. We have studied with relation to four different contexts. One is the production and efficiency oriented, second one is decision oriented, then the third is the people oriented and function oriented. I hope you have understood. Coming to the next is the nature and the scope of management. Okay, so we'll study what is the nature of management and what is the scope of management. So here, as I told you, it is first one is multidisciplinary. That means management is multidisciplinary. Why do we say? Okay, so similarly, the second point is the dynamic nature of principles, then relative, not absolute principles. Then management is a science or art. Then last one is universality of management. That means here we are trying to read about what is the scope of management here, and we are trying to read about what is the nature of the management. Now here the first point is management is multidisciplinary. Okay. So management is multidisciplinary, as in the previous classes, as we have just studied about why we term it as management multidisciplinary. Just coming to the point, multidisciplinary management, actually you can describe it as that particular management where the management of multiple departments with one or more being outside the traditional department is actually taken care. Now why we say management is multidisciplinary? Because here we are in relation to, or we are dealing with different human behaviors under dynamic conditions. So what I'm trying to say is we find different kinds of human beings in an organization, and those human beings, they have different kinds of behavior under different dynamic conditions. So therefore it depends upon the wide knowledge derived from several disciplines, so like engineering, sociology, psychology, economics, then different kinds of multidisciplinary comes into picture here. So okay. So management is multidisciplinary means we have different kinds of human behaviors under dynamic conditions in an organization. Okay. Now the second point is the dynamic nature of principles. Management has a dynamic nature of principles. What actually I am trying to say over here is, whatever the principles, management principles that we are finding out, or it is an the management principles, they are of dynamic activity, because management is that art or science where you can adjust yourself, or the management adjusts itself as per the environment is changing. So for example, you cannot say management is not rigid, but it is not rigid, it is flexible and dynamic in nature. So depending upon what kind of situations that particular organization is at that particular point of time, so depending upon what kind of environment is prevailing in and around. So based on that, so the management, what you say, management principles has that capability, or management has that particular capability to change as per the situations. Okay, so that is called dynamic nature of principles. Next is management is relative and not absolute. So what actually it means is that whatever the management principles we will be studying, those are actually relative in nature. It is not absolute. What actually I mean to say here is, this management principles we should apply according to the need of the organization. According to the need of the organization. That means we are not fixing that these are the management principle every organization has to follow. No. So according to what actually the organization needs, and according to what are the organizational goals, so this particular management principles are framed out. Okay, now a particular management principle, it has different strengths in different conditions. Therefore principles should be applied according to the prevailing conditions. So at present, what conditions are existing, as per those conditions only, as per those prevailing conditions only, we are actually applying the management principles. So that is called the management relative and or not absolute principles. Now the number four is, management is a science or art. Now management is science or art means, what I'm trying to say is, because we say management as a science because of several reasons, because there are many management principles which is totally universally accepted principles, and that universally accepted principles, management principles, is it has some cause and effect relationship. Cause and effect relationships means basing on the position, or basing on the situation, we are applying this particular management principles. So then, and at the same time, we say management is an art because it requires some kind of perfection, and that kind of perfection, that kind of perfection a particular manager will get it through practice only, and he should have some practical knowledge, and he should have some creativity, and he should have some personal skills also. So that is how we consider management as a science or art. Now number five is, management is universality of management. So management as universality of management, university of management, as we have studied. Now university of management means, as we know that the principles of management are applicable to all types of organizations, and it is applicable to all levels of organizations. So it is not that that particular manager will use the managerial skills and the management principles in each managerial position, in a particular managerial position only, no, or in a particular organization only. Universality of management means that particular management principles can be used in any organization, and those particular management principles that particular manager can use at any level of that particular organization level, whether it is lower level or the upper level organizational levels. So all those managerial skills and principles, he can use it at any point of time, at any point of time, in order to achieve the organization goals. So this is called as the universality of management. So this is all about the nature and scope of management. Now coming to the importance of management, that is, first one is the effective utilization of resources. Now in case of effective utilization of resources, as you know that the most important aspect of management is how effectively you utilize the resources that you have with you. As we have already talked about the four resources, machinery, manpower, then money and material. So if you use it in a much more effective way, that is the most important effective, how effectively you utilize the resources, it is the most important thing that you find in a management. Second one is development of resources. Development of resources means how actually the resources, how we develop. It is not that whatever the resources that we are using from last 1 or 2 years, the same kind of resources we are going to use throughout maybe the next 10 years or 10, 20 years. So the management has that particular art where the management skills or the management techniques should be framed out in such a way that always we should strive for the development of these organizational resources. Okay, so what we are talking about is things that are actually present in our surroundings and environment, which you find presently in and around you, you can use it, which the human being wants. Those are called actually resources. Now, if as per your need, if you utilize those resources, okay, that is what I'm saying. How do we develop the resources? Okay, so maybe in future you're going to develop the resources with respect to the machinery, or how do you actually improve the skills of the manpower? All these things we are talking about. Next is importance of management is to incorporate innovations. So you should have that particular criteria where the incorporation of innovation also has to be taken place. Okay, so innovation, as you all know, what I'm trying to say is you should have that particular ability where you should be able to incorporate a kind of innovation. So it is not that always you should have a same kind of method to particular solve a particular activity or to do a particular activity. So at any point of time, if you find that particular activity can be done in the best of way, whether can it be done in the simplest of the way or the best way with the minimum cost, then that particular innovative ideas also you can put it into picture. Then next is integrating various interest groups. So what I'm trying to say is we are trying, with the help of management, we try to integrate different kinds of people who are under one organization. They come in a group where they try to integrate. We form groups, then form a groups, and at any point of time, any particular problem arises in the organization, that particular groups will solve out the problem in the most easiest way. Then stability in the society. So with the help of the management, if you try to implement this particular management skills, not only in the organization, if you try to implement in our day-to-day life, and we are doing it, so it brings a kind of stability where we are working in a particular system. Okay, so we do work in a particular system, but sometimes we do go to we actually go to the other path. We are not actually concentrating on what our goals are. So if we try to bring these particular management principles into our life, or management techniques, or management, if we want to bring it as an art or science in our life, then it brings a kind of stability in the society. So this is all about the importance of management. So management as an art and science, as we have already dealt with, art, in case of art, it is practically known how to do, as we already know that art means it, these are the skills where these are the actually the skills where here the skills where the particular manager has that particular managerial skills to deal with different management aspects of that particular organization. So practically he knows how to deal with those particular problems. So management is an art. So management is a science, means it is empirically derived. So we cannot say that without any kind of proof, all these management principles has come into picture, and we are using those management principles and techniques. So it is all those things has been empirically derived. So that is why we say it's management as a science also. And why management is an art? Because we do have some different kinds of technical skills. So we say that it's an art. Art means we are talking about the skills. Then why management is a science is because it is critically tested. So we term it as management as a science. Then in case of management as an art, we have concrete results. So based upon how we are actually solving that particular kind of problem, we do have concrete results based on that. Then management as a science, it is a general principles which we take care of mainly. Then in case of management as an art, we have the creativity. Then we do find some different kinds of creative things come into picture in case of management as an art. Creative skills will come into picture. Then cause and effect relationship, that means we have to find out actually whenever we do a particular work, what is the cause, and we should have that particular idea that if we do this particular thing, this is how, if I do this particular thing, this is how I'm going to get affected. And if you know that, if you are just if you're doing that particular thing, or if you're doing that particular activity as per that, then you should also know in future, if I do this particular thing, what will be the effect of that particular thing if I'm doing it. Okay, so this is called cause and effect relationship. Next is, in case of management as an art, it is personalized nature. Then it is coming under a particular picture where it is totally personal in nature, and it is totally universal applicability. Okay, in case of management as a science. Now, in case of management as an art, it is totally personalized in nature. And what I'm talking about personalized in nature means, it is when we talk management as an art, it is totally depending upon an individual, how actually he tackles the problem individually. He has different management skills to carry out. Then management as a science means it is universally applicability. So whatever the principles that we are talking about, it is universally, those principles are universally applicable. So this is all about the management as an art and science. So this is, we'll stop here at this particular point of time. And in the next class, next lecture, we'll be dealing with the different functions of management. Okay, thank you. I hope you understood whatever that has been taught in this lecture class. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.